Hi, I'm Martin Hopley and welcome to the Marriott Dama High Resort, scene of this week's Scottish Seniors Open. I'm joined once again by Ken and John to review last week's Ryder Cup. Welcome back for Valhalla, boys. What was your highlight of the week, John?
Well, it's safe to say it was Nick Faldo's captaincy. I would have to go, I think, with the all-round performance of Boo Weekly. I think not only on the golf course, he was terrific, played some fantastic golf, but he was hilarious. I mean, off they got this, you know, imaginary horse that he seems to be riding down the fairway and around the practice green. And I mean, it's not often that I laugh out loud in public, but he made me laugh out loud on the Sunday evening during the American celebrations. He was fantastic.
Well, what about you, Ken?
Well, I think Ian Poulter's putt in the Saturday night football game when it brought Graham McDowell and he home against Jim Furyk and Ken Perry. I think the moment he held that putt and turned round to see the bank of European teammates, I think that was a great European Ryder Cup moment. And of course, it was kind of in a way synonymous of Ian's week.
Nick Faldo's captaincy has come off a lot of flack in the press since then. Do you think he could have made some decisions differently, or was he just beaten by a better team on a home soil, really, with home crowd?
No, I mean, he arrived in America with a team that was markedly better than the American teams. And I go back and forth on how much a captain can influence a Ryder Cup, but I've now come to the conclusion, having watched it this week, that a captain can very definitely lose a Ryder Cup by making decisions on the scale that Faldo did. I mean, there was two or three stuck out. I mean, obviously everyone's pointing at the, you know, having the four guys left on the golf course on the Sunday evening in the singles after the result was already decided, and that's a fairly major misjudgment, I would have to say, for somebody of Faldo's experience. But there was other things. I mean, there was one four ball series where, you know, on a golf course that had been basically set up to help the longer hitters, they'd cut the rough back and there were JB Holmes and the rest of them were blasting away with almost impunity. And we've got, in a four-ball series, when I say Europe, in the four-ball series, we've got the three biggest hitters on the team all sitting there watching. I mean, that just made absolutely no sense to me and to anybody else that I spoke to. So what Faldo was thinking in these things is a complete mystery to me. And I think he has to take an enormous share of the blame for Europe losing.
Hmm. Where are you, Ken? Are you with that?
Not really, no, not quite, in the sense that, firstly, we, all of us, have the benefit of hindsight. We can always come up with different strategies and different scenarios 24 hours or so later, and of course, we all do. But at the end of the day, on the eve of the matches, I was asked in the United States what I think needed to happen for Europe to retain the trophy. And I started by saying that we had to retain the big points that players such as Garcia and Westwood had brought to recent matches, and that the other 10 guys, led by Harrington, our double major champion, had to provide this time the points from the missing Montgomery, Clark and Donald, who were not there, as we know, for varying reasons, and who'd been also tremendous points gatherers recently. Now, as we sit here today, there were no big points from those big three players, and actually to get so relatively close as Europe did, right to almost the very end on Sunday, I think in the end maybe looked as a fairly remarkable achievement when the three leading guns, for one reason or another, did not fire.
The other side of that coin, of course, is that it really wasn't a very good American team. I mean, it was better than the team that played in 2006. At the K Club, which must be the weakest American team that we've ever seen in a Ryder Cup. But this really wasn't that great an American side. And for Europe to lose by 5 points to that team is an absolute shocker.
Well, I take issue with John on that because I point to the numbers on the board and John will have his views on the qualities of the 12 players. But the golf they played pretty much consistently throughout all five series. And certainly Sunday's singles was very representative of any recent Ryder Cup team on either side. Faldo's team matched or virtually matched them in four of the five series, but I'm very clear that I think the seeds of our defeat were sown very, very early. We lost the opening foursomes by 3-1. We played to a standard far below that of any recent European Ryder Cup team, accepting that the foursomes, of course, is and can be a very, very difficult and a difficult challenge. But for four groups to bogey or worse 17 holes in four matches was not our standard, and I think any internal review, if you like, needs to take account of that. And whoever is captain at Wales, John, one thing is for sure, we'll be starting with four balls.
Yes, I would imagine that's the case.
Well, I was thinking that. Is there any changes you think you maybe need to make, or is it just, you know, is the process is fine, or change a captain maybe?
Well, I think the captain will change. I mean, I think I'm sure, I can't speak for the European Tour, but I'm sure they're quite happy to see the back of him like the rest of us. I mean, it was an extraordinary performance by Faldo, not only in terms of the tactical and strategic things that he got wrong, but the speeches and the way he dealt with the media. I mean, the speech at the opening ceremony, I mean, was a huge embarrassment to everybody, you know, on the European side. I mean, some of the things he was saying were extraordinary. About the Irish, you know, the political scene, asking Graham McDowell, does he come from Northern Ireland or Ireland? I mean, guys from Northern Ireland just don't touch that question, and for obvious reasons. I mean, it doesn't have to be explained to anybody. And Nick Faldo blundered his way in, and at the closing ceremony, he finishes it off by saying, you know, they're saying, right, we'll see you in Wales in 2 years' time. And the last thing Faldo says is, bring your waterproofs. Now, taking no account of the amount of money that's already been spent by the people, the government in Wales and the people of Wales promoting the Ryder Cup in 2 years' time, and the last thing they need is some idiot saying, bring your waterproofs. Mm-hmm. I mean, come on.
Well, let's flip on to the positive side. I mean, Paul Daines, you know, obviously did a very good job. I mean, he's kept his secrets as to how he did it as well. Have you any insight as to what he's done? And
I'm afraid I haven't. We'll probably have to wait for the film or for the book, I would suspect. But Singer is due a lot of credit, and I think we should go there rather than continue to castigate Nick. If I could just say, perhaps not on his behalf, but on behalf of what he's brought to European golf, I think we ought to cut him a little bit more slack for being our best player for 100 years and our most successful Ryder Cupper in terms of 11 matches and the stalwart performances that he's put for us inside the ropes, if you like, firstly as a player. He could say today, not unreasonably, had Garcia won his top match and had Harrington and Westwood won the bottom matches, he'd have been bringing the cup back. And that to me shows, I think, the nature of how it could have gone the other way. But in terms of Zinger, his brilliance has been over the 2 year period of his captaincy. He has regenerated the interest of the Ryder Cup there. He modernised the selection system. As we know, I'm not in favour of any captain getting as many wild cards as Zinger demanded and got. It seemed to me in some form of desperation. Of course, those in favour of it will say that it has worked. But I think the big thing that worked for him was getting, if you like, the players in form qualified with much heavier points in this last year rather than their rather outmoded two-year system. But Isinger did a superb job as captain, and all of the positives are that American players, from the young Anthony Kim to the veteran, if you like, in Mickelson and Furyk, will want to keep playing the Ryder Cup, and that's a big positive.
Well, that's great. I think we should leave it there. Congratulations to America, and we'll look forward to hopefully getting one over them in Wales in a couple of years' time. Thank you guys for joining us. Thank you for watching. We'll see you again soon.